Namaskar, I am Pratap. Today we are going to study hospital formulary or drug formulary.
A drug is a substance which can be used for treatment, cure, prevention and diagnosis of a disease. It can also be defined as a substance which can modify or explore the physiological or pathological condition of a person for his or her benefit. The administrative form of a drug is the medicine. So all medicines are drugs, but all drugs are not medicines. Paracetamol is a drug, but paracetamol tablet is a medicine. A drug should be used rationally. When you say rational use of drug, it means the patient gets the medicine as per his clinical needs in proper dose, or you can say right dose for a right duration with minimum cost. There are many important documents to guide rational use of drugs. They are standard treatment guidelines, list of essential drugs, formulary, etc. WHO, World Health Organization, prepares a model document. Accordingly, each country and its states also prepare them. A hospital also can ensure rational use of drugs by its own formulary. Standard treatment guidelines list the preferred pharmacological and non-pharmacological treatment for common diseases experienced by people. The list of safe, efficacious, quality and cost-effective drugs is called essential drug list. This essential drug list satisfies the healthcare needs of majority of patients. In the lines of WHO modern formulary, Indian National Formulary or National Formulary of India contains the drug monographs discussing the pharmacology of drugs which are listed in essential drug list. It contains dose, use, contraindication, adverse effect, etc. Similarly, there is a physician's desk reference published by the manufacturers for the prescribers. A hospital is an institution providing medical and surgical treatment and nursing care to the patients. It can be a general hospital or specialty hospital, a government hospital or a corporate hospital. It can be associated with a medical college. Based on levels of healthcare, it can be primary, secondary and tertiary. Sub centers and primary health centers are coming under primary healthcare. Community health center CHC, sub-divisional hospitals SDH, district headquarters hospitals DHH, these are coming under secondary healthcare. The medical colleges, advanced medical research institutes, they are coming under tertiary healthcare. So the patients from primary healthcare are referred to secondary healthcare, then from secondary healthcare they are referred to tertiary healthcare to get more benefits as far as treatment is concerned. As we have discussed, essential drugs satisfy the priority healthcare needs of the majority of the population. WHO prepares a model list. In India, CDSCO prepares national list of essential medicines for India, then each state also prepares in State Medical Corporation, OSMC, prepares the essential drug list for Odisha. The selection is based on factors like disease prevalence, efficacy, safety, and cost. The disease which are prevalent differ from place to place, so disease prevalence affects the preparation of list of essential drugs. Again, efficacy and safety are for the benefit of the patient. When we say comparative cost effectiveness, we mean total price of the treatment schedule, not the unit price alone. For example, if a drug is used 3 times a day and now there is a better drug which can replace this drug and this drug can be used once daily, that means the patient will be benefited. Now in place of 3 times a day, the drug can be used once, and in that case, if the cost per unit tablet, say, if it is even more, if we compare, then as compared to 3 tablets, here we have to take 1 tablet, so it will be more effective and more cost effective. So this is called comparative cost effectiveness. So in that case, the drug which can be administered once daily should be preferred over that drug which is used 3 times a day. The formulary is a list of medicines. Essential drug list is prepared by a committee of experts as desired by the government, and the list specifies the drugs to be used in primary, secondary and tertiary healthcare. But hospital formulary, when we say hospital formulary, it is prepared for a particular hospital. The essential drug list contains only generic drugs, whereas the hospital formulary contains both generic and branded drugs. In some of the formularies, hospital formularies, they use only generic, but most often it is both generic and branded drugs. This hospital formulary is continuously revised, and it is prepared by a committee consisting of the physicians and pharmacists of the same hospital. That committee of consisting of doctors and pharmacists is known as Pharmacy and Therapeutic Committee or Drug and Therapeutics Committee. The chairman of this committee is the HOD of Medicine Department, and the chief pharmacist of the hospital acts as the member secretary for this committee. So this drug therapeutics committee or pharmacy and therapeutics committee can be constituted with clinicians and pharmacists and the administration members of the hospital. As you can see here, all the HODs, HOD medicine, HOD surgery and all other departments are the clinician members. Similarly, pharmacist in charge of inpatient, outpatient, they can be members of your drug and therapeutics committee. And the dean and the hospital director, they can be the administration members. And out of them, the HOD of medicine department will act as chairman, and chief pharmacist or chief pharmaceutical services will act as member secretary. So what is the difference between hospital formulary and drug list? Essential drug list is an example of drug list which caters the healthcare needs of population, and there is no financial implication. It includes only generic names. On the other hand, the hospital formulary caters the needs of the hospital, the patients going to that hospital. It includes both generic and brand names, and there may be financial implications. Hospital formulary is prepared by the pharmacy and therapeutics committee of that hospital, whereas the essential drug list is prepared by a committee of experts recommended by the government of that country or that state. Hospital formulary is revised every year with additions and deletions as and when necessary, but drug list is revised as and when required by the government. WHO prepares the essential drug list at fixed intervals. For different countries, it may vary from 2 to 5 years or even more. The hospital formulary system provides information for procuring, prescribing, dispensing, and administration of drugs. First, there will be appointment of pharmacy and therapeutics committee consisting of doctors and pharmacists of that hospital. They will frame the policies and procedures or guidelines. Based on those policies and guidelines, the formulary will be prepared and adopted by all the medical staffs like physicians, pharmacists and nurses. So the formulary will be prepared by the pharmacy and therapeutics committee. Usually it is published in the form of a book. This book is then distributed to each pharmacist, doctor and nurse for successful implementation. It should be available at each patient care unit. The formulary consists of a title page, then next page can be the details of the pharmacy and therapeutics committee, then there will be table of contents, after that there will be the policy and procedures which includes your the directions on how to use that formulary. Next, the actual content of the drug formulary, the details of the drugs, the items, the drugs which are added, deleted from the previous edition, then on the basis of pharmacological or therapeutic class, each drug can be then be described, and after that there can be index. There should be two types of index. One is generic or brand name index. The other is therapeutic index. So if generic name is there is no need of brand name index. Or both can be there also. And then their therapy class, that index can be there. And this indexing can be used after the description of drugs. And finally, at the end, there can be appendix to provide more information on other things. Whatever the hospital feels as necessary for the hospital for information to all, and in the end there can be different types of forms, like forms for addition to the formulary or forms for deletion from the formulary. Usually the formulary describes the generic name, brand name, dosage form, dose, strength, route of drug administration, cost, and formulation if it contains multiple drugs. Like essential drug list, here also the criteria of selection for including the drugs in the formulary will be same as that of essential drug list: safety, efficacy, quality, cost effectiveness, disease prevalence, etc. In addition to that, in the formulary, the hospital policy policy may be another factor contributing selection of drugs. There are many advantages of a formulary. There will be fewer items, so the hospital may purchase large quantities in a competitive price. It will be easy for assuring quality, procurement, storage and distribution of drugs. It will be helpful for both patients and prescribers. Patients will get quality medicines at cost effective or cheaper rate, which will improve quality of care. Patients also get more experience with drugs because less number of drugs are there. They can handle drug interaction and drug reaction in a better way. The formulary needs to be revised every year by either additions or deletions. If there is a better and safer, therapeutically better and safer drug and cost effective drug is available, then the existing drug can be replaced with that better drug. Sometimes a drug is banned by the regulatory bodies, then that has to be deleted. For example, Rofecoxib has been banned. So if the formulary contains the COX-2 inhibitor, anti-inflammatory drug, then that should be deleted. Similarly, another drug, Rosiglitazone, the thiazolidine dione, the anti-diabetic drug, that was also banned. So that can be deleted. And some examples of additions. For example, the H2 receptor antagonist, say ranitidine, has to be used twice daily, and we have proton pump inhibitors which can be used once daily. So they can replace the proton pump inhibitor can replace the H2 receptor antagonist. Similarly, previously there were sulfonylureas like glycyrrhizide, glipizide, glibenclamide, which are nowadays replaced by a better drug, glimepiride. So for addition, a formulary addition request should be submitted to the Pharmacy and Therapeutics Committee along with supporting literature. The committee may approve or deny or defer the addition of drug. Similarly, a doctor or pharmacist or nurse may suggest the Pharmacy and Therapeutics Committee to delete a drug if its usage is low and the less expensive drug with improved efficacy are available, or if the drug is banned by the regulatory bodies, as we have discussed with Rosiglitazone, Nimesulid, Rofecoxib. Sometimes in a special clinical situation, a physician needs a non-formula drug for that particular patient condition for which formula drugs have been tried and failed. When we say non-formula drug, that means the drug which is not listed in the formulary. So to do that, he must provide the literature support in favor of that non-formula drug, which says it is better than the drugs listed in the formulary. For that, the physician may request HOD pharmacy through his HOD, head of his own department, with supporting literature. Then the HOD pharmacy, in consultation with the chairman of the Pharmacy and Therapeutics Committee, may approve for procuring that non-formulary medicine. But this procurement will be only for that particular case, and it should not be generalized for other patients. And after treatment, the physician has to submit a report which will be reviewed in the Pharmacy and Therapeutics Committee meeting. That's all about hospital formulary or drug formulary. Thank you.